Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Nurse Pauline. Hope all is well today. We are gonna have a little talk. It's about self-concept, spirituality, and sexuality. This is gonna be a short video. Before I get started, I'm gonna ask you to hit your like button, hit your subscribe button, and please share my videos. Thank you. Self-concepts refers to how one sees themselves, think about themselves, evaluates themselves. Nursing concepts are the client, the health of the client, the environment. Nursing concepts introduces the following concepts: infection, safety, clinical decision making, elimination, oxygenation, immobility, tissue integrity, comfort, caring interventions, communications, stress coping, professional behaviors, culture and diversity, spirituality, and fluid and electrolyte balance. Self-concept, body image involve attitudes in relationship to patient's physical appearance, structure, or function. Body image stressors are changes of appearance, structure, or function of the body part. Identity involves internal sense of individuality, wholeness, and consistency. Role ambiguity are unclear role expectation. Role conflict, incompatible demands placed upon a person in relations to your job position. Greater role conflict is associated with the workplace. Role performance stressors are conflict, ambiguity, strain, overload. Role performance roles involve socialization, standards of behavior, roles expectation. Role overloads, having more roles than responsibilities can manage. Role strain means combination of role conflict, role ambiguity. Self-esteem stressors are low self-worth, inability to meet expectations, failure at work, failure in relationships. Families play key roles in children's development, children's sense of family, strong parental support, and parental monitoring creates positive efforts. Developmental self-concepts are parents, culture, jobs, job performance, general performances in society, job satisfaction. Adolescence is the crucial developmental stage for identity. For spirituality, nurses must be aware of the impact that their own culture and spiritual beliefs can be placed on the patient. Nurses should avoid biases. Use therapeutic communication, showing trust and caring and empathy. Spirituality is awareness of one's inner self, sense of connection to higher being. Spirituality does not need to include religious practices. In admission, assess the patient if there are any spiritual practices patients need to be observed during admission. Ask patient's permission before shaving. Some religion, they do not shave their beards. Spiritually does not mean patients are not religious. Jehovah's Witnesses may refuse blood transfusions. Seventh-day Adventists may not want, for example, any lab draws. On Saturdays, you'll have to draw their labs on Sundays instead. Self-esteem means feeling of self-worth, the overall judgment of personal worth and value. We should teach our patients relaxation techniques. Some patients are atheists. They do not believe in God. For sexuality, we should teach patients about the use of condoms. Condoms prevents spreading of sexually transmitted diseases. Condoms used with a secondary kind of birth control prevents also pregnancy. Erectile dysfunction. Nurses should be of concern about male patients who are taking diabetic medication or antihypertensive medications are among the drugs that cause sexual dysfunction. The diaphragm is a barrier type of birth control that ladies use. If you like my video, just hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and please share my video. Thanks for being here with me today. Thank you. Have a blessed evening. Be blessed. Thank you.